have about 8,000 engines in field, and one-third of those fielded engines are getting affected from sand condition problem. One rotor costs, a small rotor for a T700 engine costs about $30,000. So it's supposed to last 6,000 hours. Currently, it's lasting 400 hours. So what we are trying to do is come up with solutions, coatings, and also the material itself that can resist and tolerate high level of sand ingestion. And so that will allow us to operate in these degraded environment and also make our soldiers' lives safe.
So with this particular system, we can generate flames that are very engine relevant. So we can get good ideas of the temperatures and the flow speeds within an actual gas turbine engine using this rig. And then we can test different samples to see how well they survive that particular condition at different temperatures all the way up to 3,000 degrees F. We can not only get the thermal gradients that we actually see in the field, and we get the flow patterns that we actually see in engines. So when we start testing these materials, they're being tested at very engine realistic conditions that very few labs in the world can actually simulate.
As part of the Sandphobic research, we're working very closely with all those branches of the services, as well as other government agencies like NASA, to tackle the tough challenges that's posed by sand. And the Sandphobic coatings that we're developing here will help lead to better products and better systems for the military in the future.